Yeah, it has started. Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Please start.
Aren't you going to be saying anything?
No, ma'am. Please introduce yourself and please start.
I'll introduce myself. Now that is a real challenge. That is the biggest challenge. How does one introduce oneself? I can introduce myself as somebody who's passionate about radio and passionate about storytelling, which is what radio is all about. I can introduce myself as someone who's completely passionate about one format, which is the documentary. And of course, one can say, oh, I won so many international awards, but I don't think that really matters to all of you. I am happy to welcome. I see how many names, Gunjan? About four or five people are already here, right?
We can start. People will join in the course.
Okay. So before my PowerPoint, and I'm hoping few more people. I hope the session yesterday was very good. And by the way, everyone, hello. And I am for the first time on WebEx. Please bear with me. I'm used to interacting with a class full of people who ask me questions, and then we take it from there. So today, I don't know, Gunjan, will they be making a show of hands? Will they be sending us messages, which we will answer later? Will there be some interaction?
They can unmute themselves and then speak also.
But they need your permission, right? If everybody unmutes themselves, it will become a Tower of Babel.
I will mute them all. And if they want to ask any question, they can unmute themselves without asking your permission.
Okay, so at some intervals, I can also ask that if you all have any questions, come in, right? Okay.
Yeah, participants are requested not to switch on their videos so that the bandwidth will maintain.
Okay. So how was yesterday's class? Can I have a show of hands at least? How was yesterday's class? Isn't there some way everyone can wave? Huh. So Chintra is raising a hand. Dr. Chintra, good to see you here.
It was very good, ma'am.
Okay. And you had two very wonderful teachers, right? So
Yeah, ma'am.
Good to hear your voice. Okay. Now, I'll do a very, very small recap, which I'm sure is not really required. How to make your documentary or feature successful? And do you all know the difference between a documentary and a feature? I'm sure you know that.
Ma'am.
Lucy, good to see you here. I see lots of old colleagues. Okay. So, how to make your documentary successful? Just a recap from whatever you learned yesterday. What are the few points we remember as a recap? One is your content, of course. Then clarity. Then you create word pictures, sound pictures. Finally, it's about storytelling. So good storytelling. And how you move the acoustic energies from one to another quickly. Because, you know, the greatest fear today, at least my greatest fear, is the person who's got the knob. In the olden days, radios, there were the knobs. Now we have it in our mobiles and smart devices. He is going to switch me off if I do not grab his attention, if I do not sustain his attention. So that is my biggest fear. So what do? We just keep changing the texture, the acoustic energy. And you all know how that is done. Little bit of interview, uske baad little bit of music, uske baad sound effect. I'm sure you all know that. Then authenticity and objectivity. I'll keep coming to this point, especially if you're doing a documentary. Authenticity and objectivity. I have not come to the main topic yet, which is research. How do you ensure authenticity and objectivity? As a public service broadcaster, supposing I'm doing a topic that is a medical crisis. So what kind of experts do I take? I have to take a broad spectrum. Why? Because if you take only one expert, you're putting a lot of load on that expert to be correct. Am I getting through to everyone? And
yes,
objectivity. What is objectivity? Again, as a good journalist, as a public service broadcaster, your opinions do not matter. You have to show the mirror of the society to the public. That is my job. Like, I have done a program on diverse subjects, obviously, honor killing. I have an opinion. My program on honor killing is up on YouTube, Akashvani AIR's YouTube channel. About 62 English documentaries are up there, and quite a number of Hindi documentaries are also up there. We are getting them uploaded. When you do a subject like honor killing, I may have an opinion, but my opinion matters not. I will give you, Gunjan, echo aa rahi hai fir se. I will put up all the different viewpoints, the pros, the cons. Let everybody come into the picture. Let the listener decide. So what else? Or what is your authority also? Don't say it seems like, it feels like. This takes away authority. Be very sure. That is where your research comes in. And what is our greatest challenge is to grab the attention of the listener. You have to hook them in the beginning, pull them into the story. And what is your final challenge? Why are you making documentaries? You have to have an impact, leave an impact. What kind of impact? You know, one impact could be, does somebody want to speak? What one impact could be, somebody just smiles. I had asked Gunjan to send a feature to you all last night. It was on autism. A feature like that can move someone to action or feel more empathy. It can move you to laughter. It can move you to tears. It can move you to action. And finally, impact at the beginning is one. And the final challenge is, what is the message you leave them with? So we'll come straight to today's session, that is research. Now, if you're a documentary maker, what is the first thing you do when you have the topic? You're given a topic, right? So how do you research? Do you go straight to Google? I want to see some hands. Do you go straight to Google? Someone wants to speak. Vaishali Trivedi, yes. Yes, yes. Please tell me, what do you do? We have technical issues, Vaishali ji. I think you're breaking up both video and audio. So maybe the session for interaction. Gunjan, it's at that end, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Then please mute everybody again. Very sorry about that. Vaishali ji, I was trying to listen to you. Okay. When we started, like I started in 98 making documentaries. When we started, there was no real internet. So I remember those days when I used to go to the British Council Library and read thick, fat books. Nothing against the internet. It throws up gems. But we need to go deep. We need to check, double check. So what is research finally is search. Search again. Research. Keep searching. For a 30-minute documentary, there must be enough research which gives you the authority to speak at a seminar. That is what I believe. I'm not getting you. Very sorry. Let us, yes, maybe ma'am. Y'all can, maybe they, somebody tried to speak, Vaishali ji. Maybe she can message.
Vaishali ji ka thoda voice clear nahi tha.
Maybe she can message.
Send in chat, or maybe when network is better, she can speak.
Yeah, or send messages. Okay, so I have a PowerPoint presentation for you. Let me see. Gunjan, how many people do we have already in the class?
Just a minute, ma'am.
Yeah, how many? So should I start my PowerPoint presentation?
Ma'am, we have 15.
Okay. For me, the most exciting part of a documentary making is the research. And you all know what are we researching for? We are researching for the information related to the topic, and we are looking for the people who are going to be speaking on the topic. And since radio is an like I said, it's a storytelling medium, I'll start with a story. How many of you have heard of Feluda? Satyajit Ray's detective, a detective who is based totally on Sherlock Holmes. There is Feluda and there is a Dr. Watson, and here there's Sherlock and Dr. Watson. Here there is Feluda and Topshe, and for comic relief there is one Lal Mohan Ganguly. So I'll start with a story about one research project we did for one documentary. Here's the PPT. So I really felt that this was in Dan Brown country we were. So here's a story. Here's the story. Tell me if there is any problem reading it. Gunjan?
It is actually small. But if it is PPT, I don't know how to. Can you? Will you be able to zoom it?
Zoom it? No.
No.
Not this way. No. If I click, it goes backward and forward. No.
Okay. Should I?
This is the one I wanted people to read.
Okay. But you put it in PPT. You can directly open the MS Word document.
The MS Word document is not with me. I'll just zoom it then.
Okay. Yes, ma'am, we can see now.
Okay, then I'll just move this up. Okay, here's a story.
Yes, ma'am.
Done? Okay. So I'll just move out of the Zoom. Yeah, any problems?
No, I just came to help
you. Okay. Now, here is this Lalaji Yogendra Saxena. And he sits in a little shop in, you know, Purani Delhi Chandni Chowk area called Nai Sarat. All the shops are just stuffed with stationery. But what he is showing here would beat any Dan Brown story. He's telling us that this page of the Constitution, which all of us are very familiar with, the preamble, he's saying that this picture, please zoom on it later at home, this picture is not symmetrical as you and I have thought. He is showing us that there is a P here, there is a B here, and there is an N here, which is the initials of his Tauji, his uncle, Prem Bihari Narayan, who was given the title Raizada by the British. And Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada actually wrote our constitution by hand. This is the only constitution in the world which has fantastic illustrations, fantastic paintings, artwork that should be in a gallery. But most of us did not even know about it. At least I certainly didn't. While growing up, I read the preamble. I did not know that there are 22 plates of fabulous artwork here. And this entire thing is written by hand and it's written by calligraphy. And all the artwork was done at Shantiniketan by Acharya Nandalal Bose and his team. So what is this shopkeeper telling us? That this page was not illustrated by the Shantiniketan team. He's saying my uncle designed it, so he left his code here. This is a code. And you'll see behind him, that's his uncle, Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada. And you can see a masterpiece of art. This is the longest handwritten constitution of any independent nation of the world. So how did we stumble on this story? How do I go back? Yeah. We stumbled on the story because there was a story, there was an article about it in the internet. And below the article, you know, those conversations which people have. So there, this gentleman with the name of Saxena was countering somebody and saying, no, you are wrong. I know who wrote it, and that is person is my Tauji. Now, we could not relate because we are now researching for authenticity, how a Saxena can be related to somebody who is writing Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada. We could not understand initially. But we followed the lead, and we also followed who all are still selling stationery, especially those calligraphy pens. And that led us to this.